Welcome everyone. Today we are going to take a break from the Lego room and take a trip to Legoland and the resort. So we got to the resort at night and we purchased the $149.99 birthday package for my kids. I was not expecting much, but still excited to see what the birthday room was all about. The hotel was nice and clean. The disco elevators was a nice little touch. Then we saw our room with the tabard in front of the door, which was exciting to see upon arrival. Entering the room, it was quite large. We walked around the corner to check out the kids section and saw all the surprises waiting for them, with a stuffed animal dragon, a lanyard, and a tote bag full of goodies. Stepping away from the hotel for just a moment, here are all the items that came with the birthday package. It was a blanket, a pillowcase, tote bag, stuffed dragon, three minifigures, playing cards, a lanyard with a $20 gift card inside, a sippy cup, a couple of vouchers, one to cut in front of the line, and the second one was a slice of cake. So within the secret black combination chest, we got a polybag dog, Lego magazine, a polybag panda, and also I purchased a $12.99 voucher for three minifigures, build your own minifigures within the park. Here's the silky Lego tabard that came with the birthday package. So those of you that were curious about the playing cards, this is what it looks like inside, what the cards look like. I was a bit disappointed in the playing cards. Not one single minifigure design, even on the Joker card. I would have preferred trading cards instead. Here are the special birthday figures given to us as part of the birthday package. Again, it was a little bit limited, but steering back to the vacation, you can see the kids pool from the balcony. After the early morning complimentary breakfast, we got into the park and saw the monkeys do their monkey business. Looks like Legoland was celebrating their 25th anniversary. Displayed a big, large birthday cake right in the front. We got a chance to meet the Series 13 minifigures hot dog guy. Some baby T-Rexes hatching out of their eggs. What perfect timing. We went on a cruise to go check out some dinos. All the rides took about 5 to 10 minutes of wait time. Some of them were just straight up walking. And right over this cliff here, we spotted the Mama T-Rex So after the Dino Cruise, we took a stroll through the Lego town and headed straight for the movie sets for the Lego movie. So all these sets here were the scenes from the actual Lego movie, part one and part two combined. So the desert scene you see here in the middle probably takes up more than half of my Lego room, or if not the entire Lego room itself. Here's the kingdom scene from part one, and I don't think this is the actual boat from part one, but they have the Lego set of the boat from part one displayed here. All right, after the Lego movie walkthrough, we took a stroll through the Legoland park scenery. It was very peaceful. And then we had a nice bridge to walk over. After crossing over the bridge, we took a look at some huge Lego buildings that were, if not t as tall as me, taller than me. Huge Lego buildings. And then we have here Naya from Ninjago. We have a donkey here that's had a really rough day. So the donkey directed us to the Knight's Kingdom, where we meet a fully armored knight here. Make sure you guys go try out the barbecue at the Knight's Kingdom area. They have assorted barbecue pork, chicken, and brisket. It's definitely worth the money compared to all the other choices inside the theme park. All right, after the kingdom's visit, we were directed to the magical blue purple llama, and then from there on, the llama directed us right back to Kingdoms, where we see the infamous red dragon that you see on a lot of the pictures, as well as a few kingdom horses. Okay, after we helped the king defeat the red dragon, he directed us as a reward to the Lego store with our $20 birthday gift card. The Lego store is always the best part. Unfortunately, you cannot redeem VIP points in these Lego stores because it is not the actual Lego store itself. The life-size Lego Batman was very exciting to see. Captain America was also there, He was kind of jealous because he was much shorter. After we purchased a few souvenirs and t-shirts, we were directed right back to Ninjago, where we met Jay, the lightning ninja. We also saw Cole, the earth ninja. And there was a section for Build Your Own Ninjago Ninja. Wow, I was so tempted to get that. I was able to withstand my temptations to make a purchase, and since I passed, they redirected me to Jay the ninja. Then Jay told me to go see Lloyd. Then Lloyd told me to go see this purple bunny. Blue purple bunny. Then the blue bunny told me not to do drugs, and the cactus told me to go see the Big Ben clock tower. The Taj Mahal. I saw the Eiffel Tower. Mount Rushmore with all the presidents. The Statue of Liberty with New York City. I did forget to mention that we went back on another cruise. We went on a lot of cruises on this trip. This one was called the Coastal Cruise, and it was very peaceful. In a nice little miniature castle that had a little waterfall on it. Over here we have the workshop where the engineers designed the Lego sculptures all throughout Legoland. And I've seen these on YouTube videos where they have those air vents because they use so much glue to glue the pieces together. And the glue is, of course, is very toxic when you breathe too much of it in. And then we have Captain America again. So Captain America told me to stop filming him and go straight to Sea Life while we conclude our trip here. This was the Marine Life mixed with Lego, and it is always nice to see. Captain America warned me about this Lego babe that was in the marine life, and I did spot her. The Lego lifeguard babe said she told me to watch for a school of fish. After I passed the school of fish, we'll be headed towards the jellyfish. And if I could dodge through the jellyfish, I'd make it to safe haven with the scuba diver Lego guys and their submarine. Even though the submarine's in the water, it did need a little scrubbing. But hey, that's what happens when you own an aquarium. Lots of maintenance. That's why I took the Lego hobby instead. I'd rather clean dust than algae. So the scuba diver guys told me to look out for this lazy coworker and told me if I meet up with the coworker to tell him to get his butt back down there and to help them scrub algae off the submarine. Plus, the submarine needs detail work as well as the aquarium windows because when he's clocked in, he's at work. So I'll keep an eye out for the guy who's lounging around. This eel was in very interesting, always kind of like stuck his head out of the pot from time to time. Well, speak of the devil. Look who we see lounging around. All right, guys, thank you so much for enjoying my Lego vacation with me. I'll see you all later. Have a good one.